Hello everyone, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer, and welcome back to another episode of Skyrim Skill Analysis. Today, I'm talking about destruction, what I think about it, and what it does. So, before I begin this episode, I want to say that destruction magic in both Oblivion and Skyrim sucks. It's really boring, and they tried to kind of make it more interesting in this game, but I don't think it works well in Skyrim, just honestly. So, the perks for destruction, there's a whole bunch of paths. Really, the gist of it is you have a Frostfire Shock path, you have the path that makes it so your spells are cheaper, and you have a dual casting and a little rune path. So, Skyrim added runes, which I think was a cool concept, where you cast like a trap on the floor, basically. That's what a rune is. But in practice, really, the only way I see runes being useful is if you're fighting a boss and they're just a tank and you're trying to like bait them into the rune. So the runes can actually be extremely useful for boss fights. And I think that, you know, when you get a rune spell, you just cast it, you're like, oh, it's a trap on the floor. But when you're fighting the bosses and they're tanks and you don't always have a shot on them, runes kind of allow you to get shots on them if they're hiding, or shots on enemies if they're hiding, for that matter. So I think runes are very useful. When it comes to dual casting, there's a cool spell buff in this where if you're dual casting, you might stagger an opponent, which is really, I like that. It kind of adds to destruction other than just flaming, shocking, or frosting. Now the fire does more health damage, shock does a little bit of magic damage, and frost does stamina damage. So already, when you're using a kind of a destruction magician, I guess you could say wizard, you have to look at your opponent and pick out what kind of spells you're going to use. You know, you can do frost for the stamina. It also kind of slows them down a little bit. At least I think it does. That's how it seems with me. If you're frosting someone, they're slower. Magic lowers their magic a lot, so if you're fighting a wizard, bam, there it is. And then fire for me is for both undead and those enemies where you kind of are doing the frost and the shock and it's just not working, or they have a frost or shock shield. Then you spec out into those spells doing more damage, and then they all have a special ability where shock, if you lower the enemy's health enough, they'll disintegrate sometimes. Frost, they paralyze, and fire, they run away. These abilities are cool, but I don't see them as that game-changing, all right? Shock, random free insta-kills, right? That's what it is. Fire is, you can fire an enemy down, and then maybe you don't have to deal with them until a bit later. That's good for a lot of targets, right? And then frost, well, that was fire. Frost is the paralyze, which I can see where if there's a fast enemy or an enemy where you combine frost with something like dual casting, so you time it to where they hit a frost rune, then you have dual-wield swords or something and you just go to town on them. But I just don't see these as that cool of abilities. Like, shock, okay, yeah, fair enough. Completely just poof, someone's dead. Fire, I think it would be cool if it did armor damage. Like, I would prefer fire to do, like, you can spec it out to do armor damage. Like, what I would want is all the spell types to do some kind of extra damage, right? They'll have their one ability, maybe another one. So fire does armor, you know? Shock, I don't even know what you could do with shock. Maybe if they're metal, it does more damage, or if they're in the water, right? So, you know, they have the oil piles everywhere in Skyrim. Maybe they have just, if they're in a puddle, you know, it hurts them a lot more. Or there's like a paralysis that goes off. And frost, I think it would be really cool if you could freeze metal things and break them. So like maybe if an enemy is under frost damage, that whether it's a small chance or I don't know exactly how you do it, but you know, the sword or armor would, you know, decay over time. Granted, I mean, that would mean fire and frost do, you know, basically the same thing. Or maybe fire is, like, depending on the enemy's armor level, it damages them, right? That would be really cool. So that if you're fighting a fire guy and none of your armor does fire resistance, you'd have to take it off. But then, you know, they add a melee combat person. So I just think that destruction could use more effects. Like, I remember in Oblivion, destruction, you could also, like, damage health, damage some magic, right? Just straight up raw damage magic. Now they combine them into the spells, and what that does is it takes the spells and kind of shrinks the spell pool in Skyrim, which, granted, in Skyrim it works really well because of dual casting. I kind of think Oblivion, they went overboard with the spells, but it was just kind of, I feel like now they have room to add in some more spells, and they didn't. They just shrunk it up and made it easier to manage. So overall, I think destruction, it's destruction magic. It's just basic magic damage, and that's what you get out of it. I think that personally, it's a good skill to have for sure, especially if you're not using bows, but I just think that it's not a very unique spell set. So let me know what you guys think about it in the comments below. Subscribe if you're new for more Skyrim skill analysis. I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer. I suck just as bad as you do at video games. And I'll see you in the next episode, stream vlog, or Steam it post, or whatever I decide to make.